Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Monday of the fourth week of Easter. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphone. Christ, having risen from the dead, dies now no more. Death will no longer have dominion over him. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, perfect light of the blessed, by whose gift we celebrate the Paschal mysteries on earth, bring us, we pray, to rejoice in the full measure of your grace for ages unending. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The apostles and the brothers who were in Judea heard that the Gentiles too had accepted the word of God. So when Peter went up to Jerusalem and the circumcised believers confronted him, saying, "You entered the house of uncircumcised people and ate with them." Peter began and explained it to them step by step, saying, "I was at prayer in the city of Joppa, when in a trance I had a vision, something resembling a large sheet coming down, lowered from the sky by its four corners, and it came to me. Looking intently into it, I observed and saw the four-legged animals of the earth, the wild beasts, the reptiles, and the birds of the sky. I also heard a voice say to me, 'Get up, Peter, slaughter and eat.' But I said, 'Certainly not, sir, because nothing profane or unclean has ever entered my mouth.' But a second time a voice from heaven answered, 'What God has made clean, you are not to call profane.' This happened three times, and then everything was drawn up again into the sky. Just then three men appeared at the house where we were, who had been sent to me from Caesarea. The Spirit told me to accompany them without discriminating. These six brothers also went with me, and we entered the man's house. He related to us how he had seen the angel standing in his house, saying, 'Send someone to Joppa and summon Simon, who is called Peter, who will speak words to you by which you and all your household will be saved.' As I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell upon them, as it had upon us at the beginning. And I remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said, 'John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit.' If then God gave them the same gift he gave to us when we came to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I to be able to hinder God?" When they heard this, they stopped objecting and glorified God, saying, "God has then granted life-giving repentance to the Gentiles too." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Athirst is my soul for the living God.
Athirst is my soul for the living God.
As the hind longs for the running waters, so my soul longs for you, O God. Athirst is my soul for God, the living God. When shall I go and behold the face of God?
Athirst is my soul for the living God.
Send forth your light and your fidelity. They shall lead me on and bring me to your holy mountain, to your dwelling place.
Athirst is my soul for the living God.
Then will I go in to the altar of God, the God of my gladness and joy. Then will I give you thanks upon the harp, O God, my God.
Athirst is my soul for the living God.
Alleluia, alleluia. I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my sheep, and mine know me. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever does not enter a sheepfold through the gate but climbs over elsewhere is a thief and a robber. But whoever enters through the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens it for him, and the sheep hear his voice. As the shepherd calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has driven out all his own, he walks ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they recognize his voice. But they will not follow a stranger. They will run away from him because they do not recognize the voice of strangers. Although Jesus used this figure of speech, the Pharisees did not realize what he was trying to tell them. So Jesus said again, "Amen, amen, I say to you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved and will come in and go out and find pasture. A thief comes only to steal and slaughter and destroy. I came so that they may have life and have it more abundantly." My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So today we continue the image of the good shepherd. No? And again, I guess it's good to deepen our reflections from yesterday. No? First three points, no, to take a look at the gospel for today. No? It gives different, you might say, it deepens different characteristics of the good shepherd. Number one is that, that closeness and that intimacy, no, between the shepherd and his flock, the shepherd and his sheep, no? And second is that image of the sheep gate. This is a very interesting detail that would be good to reflect on, no? And finally, that beautiful ending to this gospel. I came so that they might have life and have it more abundantly, no? So first about that closeness of the sheep, no, and the shepherd, no? And here the Lord says, so he uses the image of, they hear my voice and they follow me. I don't know if you remember, maybe around 3 or 4 years ago, I shared with you a story of someone who shared this story with me. No, she lives in LA. No, this is around two years before the pandemic. I was talking to her about, we celebrated the Mass with this gospel. And she shared with me that story one time. She lives in LA, no? And one time there was a traffic jam in one of the freeways, one of the highways in LA, no? Because what happened was that there was a herd, no, of sheep that went into the highway and slept on the highway. They slept, no, on the road, no? So there was a big traffic jam, no? So of course, you know how it is in the US, ano, yan, medyo drama yan, ano? May mga fire truck, may mga ambulance, may mga police, they all came, no? Trying to let the herd, no, go leave the highway, no, and but they were all lying down there, no, so they were being featured in the local news channel, no, and they were saying they were watching it, and then all of a sudden the shepherd came, no, and the shepherd supposedly fell asleep, no, while guarding the herd, no, and the shepherd, presumably, I guess the shepherd was Mexican, no, and spoke, no, in Spanish, called out to the sheep, no, and this friend of mine was telling me that you could see it in the TV as he called out in Spanish, the sheep all raised their heads and looked all in one direction towards the voice of the shepherd. So here you have the Lord using, no, a very familiar image to the people, no. Because it is true, no, that when the voice of the shepherd is heard by the sheep, no, they immediately follow the voice, no. And I guess that is the kind of intimacy, no, that the Lord is talking about, no, that you are my sheep, I am your shepherd, no. And for me, that's a very, very tender image, no, a very tender image of closeness and intimacy, no. And then the second point is the sheep gate, and this one is very interesting because, according to one commentary that I read, no, that so every night the shepherd brings his flock or his herd into the cage or the pen, no, and then sometimes there is no gate, so the shepherd sleeps to block the gate, no, and therefore to protect the sheep, no. So that is why I am the sheep gate. So that is literally laying down his body, no, as a protection for the sheep, no. And I guess the second point that I invite you to reflect on. Remember what we were talking about last week, no, that in the end, the deepest meaning of our lives when we find something or someone for which we are willing to die for, we're willing to commit totally our lives, no? And guess this image again of the Lord being the sheep gate, no? Guarding the flock, bodily protecting the flock, is one of those, you might say, symbols, no? Of that total dedication, something to die for, something to offer and dedicate our lives to. And I think the third and final point gives us the deeper meaning or reason of what it means to dedicate our lives to something, willing to die for. As the Lord said it at the very end, He said, I came that they might have life and have it more abundantly. When you reflect on this, this is the fulfillment of God's mission. Dying on the cross, His offering of His life in loving obedience to the will of God. And truly, no, the Lord came that you might have life, eternal life, and have it more abundantly. Siguro maganda na pagnilaya natin itong ebanghelyo muli tungkol sa mabuting pastol. Pagpapalalim ng ating mga pagninilay kahapon, ano? Kagaya nga ng nabanggit natin kahapon, yung cura personalis, yung mahalagang napaka-personal at napaka-malapit at personal at mapagkalingang relasyon o ugnayan doon sa pinuno, sa kanyang kawan o yung pastol at ang kanyang kawan. At ito'y naglalarawan sa atin ng kung gaano kalapit ang Diyos sa atin, ang Panginoon sa atin, kung gaano tayo kalapit sa Kanya. No? Kagaya nga nung nabanggit kong ehemplo kanina, may kinukwento sa akin yung isang kaibigan kong tiga LA, no? Na siguro ito mga 2 years bago magpandemya. Kinukwento niya na merong isang kawan ano, ng tupa na natulog sa highway. At kahit anong ginawa ng mga pulis, mga bombero, mga ambulansya, nagdatingan lahat doon, so pinapakita sa local news, ano, hindi gumagalaw yung mga tupa, ano, natutulog sila doon sa highway. Tapos biglang-bigla dumating yung ano nila, yung pastol, no? Kasi parang nakatulog ata yung pastol according to the news. Nakatulog siya, Meksikano. At tapos nung pagdating niya, nakita niya nga nagkakagulo na, tinawag niya yung kanyang kawan, ano? At tinawag niya sa Kastila, no, sa Meksikano, no. At biglang-bigla kinukuwento nung kaibigan ko sa news, makikita mo sa TV, nung nadinig nung kawan yung boses nung pastol, bigla na lang nagtinginan sabay-sabay tungo dun sa boses. Yung ganung kalapit, ano, totoo itong imahe na ginapit ng Panginoon, ano? Ganung kalalim yung ugnayan ng pastol at ang kanyang kawan. At ito isang ano, napaka-personal at napaka-mapagkalingang ugnayan, ano? Siguro yung unang punto na yan. Ano? Yung pangalawang punto ay yung sabi ng Panginoon, ako ang pintuan, ako ang sheep gate. Yung sabi nga no, isang komentaryo, yung kasi meron niyang kulungan, yung pen. Ano? Tapos yung ibang pen, yung ibang kulungan, walang pinto. Kasi doon natutulog yung pastol. Siya mismo ang pinto. Siya ang nagbibigay proteksyon sa kanyang kawan. Ano? Para alam niya kung may darating na lobo o ano na sasaktan yung kanyang kawan, ano. Pero literal to, no, na pag-aalay ng katawan upang protektahan ang kanyang kawan, ano. Ganung klaseng pagtatalaga ng sarili. Sabi nga natin tong nakaraang linggo, no, isang pinakamalalim na kahulugan ay pag na-discover natin ang isang bagay o isang tao o isang masasabi nating misyon na handa tayong mag-alay ng buhay. Kagaya ng imahen na nahihiga ano, para protektahan yung kawan. At yung pangatlo, tuling punto ay yung katapusan ng ebanghelyo ngayong araw. No? Ako'y naparito upang sila, tayo, no, ay magkaroon ng buhay at buhay na, ano, na talagang abundant. Ano? Siguro napakagandang imahen nun kasi yun ang krus. Ano? Na yung masasabi nating masaganang buhay na binibigay sa atin ng Panginoon ay ang buhay na walang hanggan, ano, sa pamamagitan ng kanyang krus at muling pagkabuhay. Today as we reflect again on the image and the gift and the grace of the Good Shepherd, let us pray that we may recognize Christ as our Good Shepherd. And more than this, I think let us pray that we will be given the grace to be good shepherds to the people who have been entrusted to our care. The Lord is the good shepherd who knows each one of his flock by name. Let us offer our prayers to God, trusting in his personal love for us.
That the Holy Father, God's chosen shepherd, may lead us into the ways of righteousness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christian believers may become one flock under one shepherd. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our young people may have life and have it to the full through fidelity to the Good Shepherd. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And we continue to pray for the good health of Pope Francis, our shepherd. And let's also pray for his intentions, especially his prayers for peace and for all. And let's also pray for the coming synod on synodality. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit perpetually through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself, but defends us and even pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer for the Easter season.
Risen Lord, may the joy of this season inspire us to renew our friendship with you as your companions in mission. Open our mind, heart, and spirit to the truth and grace of sacred scripture, and may the story of the journey of your disciples and the early church renew our own journey of mission in our world today. Enliven our faith that we may do all things in joyful, loving obedience, and witness to the saving power of your cross and resurrection. May we be a sign of hope in our world today and bring the victory of your cross and resurrection over the evil of violence, injustice and war, over sin and death. Risen Lord, make our hearts burn within us that we may set our world on fire with the love and mercy of your heart. Amen.
And let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat, and have a good day ahead and have a good week ahead. Thank you very much for joining us.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk on water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.